Good morning, and welcome to today's edition of Stephen Whiteside's Stock Market Timing Television. Each day at this time, Stephen takes a technical look at the markets, including the S&P 500, NASDAQ, gold, crude oil, as well as the most widely held leveraged ETFs. This video is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's video newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Monday, June 7th, 2010. In the pre-market on Monday morning, we've got stock index futures slightly above fair value. Both gold and crude oil are trading pretty close to unchanged at the present time. So quiet open Monday morning at 9:30. Starting off this morning, looking at some weekly charts, no major changes last week. We're in our fifth week of a major down move for the S&P 500. We're in our sixth week of a major up move for the VIX. As long as the VIX stays in a weekly uptrend, we should expect wide-ranging days, lots of volatility. That's to be expected. Looking at bank stocks, they've come down to the recent lows once again. They are certainly leading this market lower. We've got the NASDAQ, the SOX and gold stocks all still trading in the channel on the weekly chart. So while they're weak, they are certainly stronger than the major indexes and the bank stocks. Taking a look at the U.S. dollar, still in a major up move. We're coming up to major resistance up at the 90.83 area on the U.S. dollar index, and that will present a major area of resistance and certainly a target to the upside. Looking at gold, still in a major uptrend, still having trouble at 1250. Copper in a major downtrend now, broken down below the 2010 lows. That's not a good sign. Crude oil was weak last week. Natural gas finally broke out of the trading range it's been in for the last couple of months. That's a good thing. Bonds, they're still in an uptrend on the weekly charts, had a big reversal on Friday. Looking at a couple of daily charts, the S&P 500 is still below its 200-day moving average, and that is acting as resistance, whereas technology stocks in the NASDAQ and the SOX are still trading above the 200-day moving average, and that's acting as support. Moving over, looking at the daily charts, S&P 500, we need a daily close above 1103.26 on Monday to give us a new buy signal. For bank stocks, we're looking for a daily close above 144.97. For the VIX, we're looking for a close above 35.80 to tell us that this current downward pressure in the stock market will continue. Looking at the NASDAQ, we need a daily close below 1830.33 to give us a sell signal on Monday. For the SOX index, we're looking for a daily close below 346.84 on Monday to give us a new sell signal. For the XAU for U.S. gold stocks, we're looking for a daily close above 175.84. We rolled over to a daily sell signal on Friday. Looking at the U.S. dollar, we need a daily close below 86.24 to give us a sell signal on Monday. For the euro, we're looking for a daily close above 124.10. For the bonds, we had a big reversal day on Friday. We had a sell signal on Thursday, and we closed above the upper channel line on Friday, which is a new buy signal. I'm going to wave that one off. We're up at the top of the panic zones. The next target to the upside is 140.63, so I'm not going to be taking this long signal on Monday, but I will certainly be closing out my short position at the open on Monday morning. Looking at crude oil, we're now on a sell signal once again. A daily close above 73.14 would give us a buy signal. And for natural gas, we had a nice big move to the upside on Thursday, follow through on Friday, and that's certainly broken us out of the trading range we've been in since early April. A daily close below 4.31 on Monday would give us a daily sell signal for natural gas. Looking at gold, we're looking for a daily close below 1208.94 on Monday to give us a sell signal. For copper, we need a daily close above 367 to give us a buy signal. Moving over, looking at the 60-minute charts for Monday's trading activity, we can remain bearish on the S&P 500 as long as we don't start closing above 1086.18 on an hourly basis on Monday. We could remain bullish on the VIX, which is negative on the stock market, as long as we continue to trade above 32.29 on Monday. For bank stocks, we're looking for an hourly close above 138.92 to give us an intraday buy signal on Monday. For the NASDAQ 100, we're looking for an hourly close above 1867.93 to give us a buy signal. For the SOX index, we're looking for an hourly close above 357.72 to give us a buy signal. And for the XAU, we can remain bearish on gold stocks on Monday as long as we continue to trade below the 172.18 area on an hourly basis. Okay, that's all for Monday morning, folks. Have a great day. We'll talk to you again on Tuesday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.